Hi everyone, Shashank this side. I hope you all are doing well today and safe as well. I know this is a tough time for all of us fighting against COVID-19 virus. So please stay at home to break this chain and we'll keep our faith on our medical staff to get the medication out as soon as possible and kill this virus. Okay. Continuing to our video series, today we will look at new feature introduced in 2019 reInvent for IAM, which is called IAM Access Analyzer. This is a good service from AWS which help us to analyze our access rights on accounts, policies, buckets, and so on. And to be honest, this is simple to configure with a good amount of findings we get on how to secure our policies, buckets, or users' rights and everything, right? So this will help us to analyze all those data. So let's review this first on the theoretical side, followed by our practical demo. Okay, so as I said, this is a new feature invented or introduced in reInvent 2019 by AWS. So this makes it simple for the security team and the administrator to check whether their policies provide only the intended access to the resources. For example, you have created multiple resources with multiple policies. As an example, I'm just supposing that. There are a few policies which gives you a full permission. For example, operations team. So operation team doesn't require a full access to all of the resources. They require a certain level of access. By mistake, somebody created a policy with full rights, with a full potential, and someone from operation can have a power to delete everything. So with the help of Access Analyzer on the IAM side, we can analyze that policy, we can restrict that policy for a particular team or a particular group so that a proper rights given to all the members. So resource policies allow customer to gradually control who is able to access the specific resource and how they are able to use it across your entire cloud environment. As I said, based upon the policy, we define our access rights because the policy is something called a documents or a permissions within AWS IAM. And again, if you're not aware of the IAM policies and what IAM is all about, the first series of video was created by me on IAM itself. It consists of all the architectural view of an IAM. So I'll share the video link. Please go through that particular playlist, which has a number of videos in it that will help you to understand how IAM works. Okay, customers can enable IAM Access Analyzer across their accounts to continuously analyze permissions granted using their policies associated with their S3 buckets, whether your buckets are public or non-public. KMS keys, encryption and non-encryption has been done or not properly, whether you are rotating your keys or not. Amazon SQS queues, IAM roles, and Lambda functions. So as of now, these are the things that we can check around with IAM Access Analyzer. So what are the benefits we have? We can save our time to analyze different kind of policies that somebody has created, right? And we have to rectify them. So the only problem that I can see with the Access Analyzer, you have to rectify your problems manually. Although you can write some Lambda function or some kind of automation we can do to rectify the problems automatically as well. So there is a provision of that in AWS as well. Continuously monitors and help us to refine our permissions and provide the highest level of security assurance. So that's how beneficial IAM Access Analyzer is. One console, and you can analyze your right proper permissions basically across your AWS accounts as well. One thing to remember, Access Analyzer is region specific. So IAM is global in nature, but IAM Access Analyzer is region specific. So this is the architectural flow basically. You have to create an analyzer. So once analyzer is created, this will be going to review all the modules associated with it with a proper permissions. So let's say if you have a bucket with public access, this will show you the bucket list, that these are public buckets, these are non-public buckets, right? So you have to rectify your bucket permission, and then you have to take an action. If access to the resource is not intended, by mistake somebody has given that access, modify the resource policy to further restrict the access. If access to the resource is intended, then you can archive your finding. So there are like two level of operation we can do. One is rectify your problem, resolve it. Second, if you have intentionally given a permission, then you can archive that result. So I hope this clears a lot in terms of the Access Analyzer, why AWS has created this module to help us to check the proper permission has been given on our accounts or not. So let's jump to our AWS Management Console. I'll show you how to do the configuration. This is my AWS Management Console. To get into Access Analyzer, we have to go to IAM. Okay. So as I said, IAM is global in nature, but Access Analyzer is region specific. So if you go inside Access Reports, we have Access Analyzer. Click on this. Now, this is first time I'm going to create my Access Analyzer. Let's close this. Now, monitor access to resources. Create analyzer. How this works, create your analyzer, then review the active findings and take actions. That's how simple it is. So let's click on create analyzer. You can give the name of the analyzer. Let's say test access. You can do the tagging as well. The current account is this one. Create analyzer. Now, here it's creating an analyzer. So this will going to take like less than a minute to properly creation, and this will going to find all our resources, like the intended permission has been given or not. Based upon that, we can take our actions to rectify all those problems. So as of now, I have, I guess, only one with write access. Let's wait for this to complete. Analyzer creation is completed. So I have only one resource policy, which is from IAM, which has write access to this account. So this is another account that I have used. Let's click on this. Check the finding. Resource, you can see the resource. This is a role basically where all the rights has been given. It's an assumption role. Let's click on this. This will redirect me to the role section of IAM, which is again global in nature. We can see the trust relationship. This is an inline policy which has, let's wait for access, full access to all the resources, which is obviously, if it is intended, it's fine. But if it is not intended, not intentional in nature, then you have to rectify this. And how you can rectify this? You just have to either update your inline policy or the policy that you have applied. Now, what I'm going to show you, let's go to S3 console. I'm not going to rectify this particular resource because this is intended for me. So I'm not going to touch this. Let's go to analyzer. Now, I have four buckets, and all buckets are not public in nature. So that's why if you go to Access Analyzer for S3, it has, again, it's in Northern Virginia that I have my buckets, and I have created Access Analyzer in Northern Virginia. So let's go to Northern Virginia. So I don't have any bucket which is public in nature. Now what we can do, like, let's say if your bucket is public in nature, then Access Analyzer will again going to run in next 30 minutes. And this will analyze the buckets as well. If your bucket is public in nature, then this will gonna list the bucket as well. So permissions, access control list. Let's give this bucket as write access. Save it. Now my bucket is public in nature. This bucket is public. Let's go to Access Analyzer. Now, read this particular message. The bucket listed below are configured to allow access by anyone using internet. Since my bucket is public and any unauthorized access can be done on my bucket can be hacked as well. If I place some confidential data, then anybody can hack this bucket because we don't have any policy created on that or any kind of restriction has been done on that. Now, Access Analyzer generates and updates the finding based upon the change within 30 minutes. Findings related to the account level block public access settings may not be generated or updated up to 6 hours after you change the settings. So we have to wait for this analyzer to generate some data. So once the data is generated, then we will going to see that particular bucket list in our analyzer. So if we go to analyzer detail, I'm in Mumbai region. Let's go to Virginia. Now we have like two options, archived and resolved. Since this is intended, so I can move this to archive. So this will go into the archive. So with next round of scanning, this will going to show me the S3 bucket because that is public in nature. And if that is also intended, then I can move that to archive. And if I have to resolve that is not intentional in nature, then I have to go to my S3 bucket and remove everyone access from that bucket. Then that will automatically move to the resolve state. So this is how Access Analyzer works with different kind of modules or services that associated with Access Analyzer. I hope this clears a lot why we use Access Analyzer or why this has been implemented. So I'll be sharing the Amazon link as well with a detailed review what we have with Access Analyzer, like a detailed documentation with my video description. Please go through that. And that's it guys for this particular video. Try it out on your account, and this is free of cost as per my understanding. There is no costing for using IAM Access Analyzer, but I'm gonna cross check right away. Let's open AWS IAM Access Analyzer. To best of my knowledge, this feature is free. Let's go to pricing. We don't have any pricing model over here. Yep, so you'll not be going to get charged while using this particular module. So just play it around on your account. Try to analyze your policies. Try to analyze your S3 buckets. If you're facing any issue with this particular module or service, place out a comment in comment section and I'll be there to help you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.